So today is lecture number 15 of this introduction to physical metallurgy class, and here are the contents, that is designating or indexing, or you can say Miller indices for crystallographic points, crystallographic directions. And second one is symbol used to represent crystallographic points, direction, planes, family of direction, family of planes, an equivalent direction in cubic crystals. Okay, so these are the contents. So basically, in this today's lecture, you will be introduced with different planes, different directions, and points in the crystals. Basically, here we'll take a unit cell, and in that unit cell, you can have lot of directions, lot of planes. Planes means I'm talking about atomic planes. You can have a lot. Directions means from one lattice point to another lattice point, right? That is a direction, a vector actually. Direction is nothing, a vector which is connecting one lattice point to another lattice point. So points mean any points inside the unit cell. So here Miller indices means it is a kind of designations, you can say. So Miller indices is a form of notation. You can say it is a form of notation. Like we denote a particular plane or a particular direction or a particular point by a particular notation. That is called Miller indices basically. And you have to remember, Miller indices is basically for like three coordinate system. Basically, like cubic crystals is a three coordinate system. So we'll stick with cubic crystals because most of the metals we see around, or most of the metal in the periodic tables, comes under cubic system. Either they are FCC or they are BCC. A few of them also in HCP. We'll discuss that in the coming lecture. That is four coordinate system. If it is FCC, it is four coordinate system. That is called Miller-Bravais indices. But this is simply called Miller indices. This is three coordinate system, which is used for cubic crystals. Because in a cube, we have x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis, right? But in case of a hexagonal structure or in HCP, we have four coordinate. A1, A2, A3, and a c-axis. Or a z-axis will be there. I'll show you in the coming lecture. Okay. And in this today's topic also, we'll be seeing how to represent those planes, how to represent those directions and those points. And if the directions are coming under a single family, how to represent them, or what is the symbol? And if the planes are coming to a single family, how you can represent them, right? Or what is the symbol for them? So before moving into that, let us discuss the conclusion of the previous lecture, that is about symmetry. So finally, the question is, why most of the metal occurs in cubic crystal form? Nearly 80 to 90% of metal from periodic tables are cubic. They may be FCC, they may be BCC, or some are simple cubic, like polonium, if you remember. Otherwise, most of the metals occur in FCC form, BCC form, all or simple cubic. All comes under this cubic crystal system, right? So this is the question. So answer is simple, because every metal tried to be more symmetric. So, and moreover, most of the metals we have are either cubic, FCC, BCC, or hexagonal, or that is HCP. Because cubic and hexagonal possess higher symmetry. If you remember, I have shown you the symmetry in cubic system and hexagonal system. The cubic system has highest symmetry, right? Do you remember which crystal system have the lowest symmetry? Or there is no symmetry at all?
Cubic.
My question was, which crystal system have lowest symmetry, or there is no symmetry at all? Out of seven crystal system, the cubic have highest symmetry. we have seen that. Triclinic.
Triclinic lowest.
Yes, triclinic. Is there any metal with triclinic? There is another question. Is there any metal with triclinic system? That is one fold symmetry only. Answer is no. We don't have any metals which are in triclinic form, right? Because it is having the lowest symmetry, right? Or there is no symmetry at all. One fold symmetry means there is no symmetry, you can say also. Because if you rotate the triclinic by 360 degree, then only you can reproduce the same structure. So that's why it is one fold symmetry. And so no metals we have. So that means the final conclusion is most of the metal in the periodic table are either FCC or BCC, and few of them comes under HCP. Because cubic system and hexagonal system have highest symmetry possible, fine? And metals want to be remain in symmetric form, fine? Okay, so now we come to our main topic, that is crystallographic points. So now this is a question. Locate a crystallographic point that is 1 by 4, 1, 1 by 2 in the given unit cell. So this is a given, just have a look. This is a given unit cell we have. What are these? Who can answer what are these? These are what?
Edges.
These are edges. What is written over here? What are these? These are the lattice parameters.
Yes.
These are the lattice parameters. A, B, and C. This is in the X axis, this is A. In the Y axis, this is B. And in the Z axis, this is C, right? All the values are given here in nanometer scale, right? And this, just have a look to the this X axis, this is Y, and this is Z. So now the question is, we have to locate a point whose magnitude is 1 by 4, 1 and 1 by 2. What it means? That means there is a point in, we have to locate a point inside this unit cell having this kind of magnitude. So in X axis, it should be 1 by 4. In Y direction, it should be 1. And in Z direction, it should be half. It is okay? Fine. So how to represent that? Just how to start? The first point is just draw the unit cell. Already unit cell is there. You have to mark X axis, Y axis, and Z axis. Then you take the origin. So this one will be your origin. Just have a look. The crusher, this is your origin. Origin means 0, 0, 0. Right? In X direction, it is 0. In Y direction, it is 0. In Z direction also, it is 0. Magnitude is 0. You people have understood up to this?
Yes, sir.
You show the 3 axis first. Then you choose a origin. Origin is chosen here. That is 0, 0, 0. Now, in X axis, the magnitude is 1 by 4. So what you need to do? You need to travel in the X direction by 1 by 4 magnitude. So this, suppose this is the length, you go to 1 by 4. Suppose this is the point I have reached right now, 1 by 4 distance, right? Then I'll stop over there. Next is, the magnitude is, in Y direction is 1. So you have to move to 1 unit distance completely. So I'll move in this direction to 1 unit distance and I'll stop over here. It is okay up to this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then finally, this is half. This is half in Z direction. So you have to move a half distance. I'll move like this up to this one. So this is your reason. This is your point, location. Question was locate a crystallographic point. The location of the crystallographic point will be this one. Fine? This point. So how, again, I am showing you. You start with 0. you move 1/4 distance in x direction. Suppose this is completely one magnitude, one unit magnitude. So you move to 1/4 distance, then you stop. Then again in y direction, you have to move to one, completely one unit distance like this. Then finally, in the z direction, you have to move to half. So half distance will be here. Fine, I will stop over here now. So this is, this point is the location of this one. Fine. So if you want to calculate the magnitude of that, this is very simple, because x-axis value is given, y direction value is given, z direction value is given, right? So you have to multiply that simply. So that means in the x direction, it will be 1/4 into 0.48 nanometer. It is written over here, right? That will be 0.12. Then in y direction, what is the magnitude? That will be 1 into 0.56. That is 0.56. Then in z direction, it will be 0.5 multiplied with 1/2. That will be 0.25. So the point having, the point will be here, and that point will be of magnitude this one. 0.12, 0.56, 0.25. It is okay now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next, now this is another very beautiful question, that is locate all lattice point in the given BCC unit cell. So just have a look. This is a BCC unit cell because atoms or lattice points are at the corner of the cube and one atom is sitting at the body center position. So this is BCC, body centered cubic. And once it is cubic, what will be the lattice parameter? How many of you have remember? In case of cubic, all edge length will be same, right? A is equal to B is equal to C. So that's why they have written this is also A and this is also A. And in the Z direction also, this is A, right? Because A is equal to B is equal to C. So you can write A only for this edge length, this edge length, and this edge length, right? Now you have to locate all the lattice point which are numbers are given already, huh? This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, 5, this is 6, this is 7, this is 8, and this is 9. So lattice points numbers are already written over here, 1 to 9. But what is the point coordinate for first one? So just tell me quickly. Let me see if you can answer.
First one 0, 0, 0.
0, 0, yes, 0, 0, 0, 0. Very good. Next one will be 2.
1, 0, 0. 1, 0, just, 0, 0.
Sorry, can you repeat?
1, 0, be, 0.
Very good. This will be 1. Then it will be 0 and 0. Why this is 1, 0, 0? Because see, first one is, this one is 0, 0, 0 because it is origin. So there is no magnitude in x direction, y direction, and z direction. So it is 0, right? But this point 2 is here. That means from origin, you are moving a 1 unit distance in the x direction. So that is 1. But now the point is present over here, right? So in y direction, there is no value. In z direction, there is no value. So it will be 0, 0. Very good. So what about the point 3?
1, 1, 0.
Okay, fine. So this will be, see how you can move. You first start from the origin. You move in the x direction, 1 unit distance. Then in y direction, you move like this. That is again 1 unit, right? But in the z direction, there is no movement. So it will be 1, 1, 0. It is okay now?
Yes, sir.
What about 4?
0, 1, 0.
Yeah, it will be, this is the origin again. So you start with, that means since the point is here, so we don't want to move in the x direction, right? Because we have to reach here, right? So this will be like 0 in the x direction, and in the y direction we'll move like this. So 1, but in the z direction there is no movement. So this will be 0, 1, 0. It is okay. What about the 5?
Half.
Okay, very good. So I want to reach at this point. Fine. So I'll start with, so this point is, you just imagine a cube is there and the body center of the cube, a point is there, right? So how to reach that center point? So I will travel half distance in the x direction, then half distance in the y direction, and half distance to the z direction, like this. It is okay? So it will be half, half, half. Very good. What about c? Sorry, c.
0, 0, 1.
It will be okay, fine. In the 6 point is here. So in the x direction I will not move, in the y also I will not move, or z direction I will move in this direction. Okay, so this will be 0, 0, 1. Okay. What about 0.7?
1, 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1.
Okay, fine. So point is here. So how to reach that point easily? So better to travel in the this is here, right? So you will move from here to here. If this will be the point, so x direction it is 1, y direction you will not have to move, but in the z direction you have to move to this point. Okay, fine. So this will be 1, 0, 1. It is okay, 1, 0, 1.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What about 0.8?
1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1.
Okay, fine. You have to. You, the origin is here. You start like this. 1, 1 magnitude. In y direction it is 1 magnitude, and finally you will reach to here. So this will be 1, 1, 1, and 1. Okay, very good. What about the 9 point?
0, 1, 1.
Yeah, in 0. So that means to reach this point, you don't move to move in the x direction. So x direction will be 0. In y you have to move in 1 unit magnitude, and in z here. Okay, fine. This will be 0, 1, and 1. I think everybody have understood this one. How to find out a point in a unit cell or any given unit cell. You can locate it, fine? These are called point coordinates. Yes. So now, this is an assignment. Draw a FCC unit cell. You have to draw a FCC unit cell first. Then you have to show different coordinates, X, Y, Z. And finally, you have to show all the points, coordinates. That means you have to draw an FCC unit cell first. You have to show the location of atoms present in the FCC unit cell, and you have to find out the point coordinates of each atoms, the corner atoms, the face centered atoms. Huh? This is an assignment. Huh? You try by yourself. Huh? This is very easy. Because already I have shown you the projection in the previous lecture. Hmm. Okay, now we'll move to the directions. So as I told, crystallographic direction means it is a vector. Huh? It is a vector connecting one lattice point to another lattice point. Fine. Simply. Vector means it has magnitude as well as direction. Huh? It is a vector. So it is a direction vector, you can also say. Fine. So now the question is draw. Okay, fine. Just have a look. This square bracket means basically for a crystallographic directions, we use this kind of symbol. If this is a square bracket, that means you understand this is a crystallographic directions. So I have one direction, this is another direction, this is another direction, because all are in square bracket, fine? And this three values means these are Miller indices, as I told. Huh? Miller indices is for three coordinate system, like cubic system. Hmm. This one is for x-axis, this one is for y, and this one is for z. Fine. So, that means the question is, a cube is given already. Huh? And you have to draw this 1, 0, 0 direction. This is 1, 1, 0 direction. And this is 1, 1, 1 directions. You have to draw this direction in this unit cell, cubic unit cell. Fine. So, this is also very easy. Huh? So just have a look. First, I want to draw this 1, 0, 0 direction. So how to draw it? So you, first of all, if there is a question like this, you first draw a cube. Then after drawing a cube, next step is to show the x coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate. Then you make it origin. This is the origin we are choosing now. So now this, that means, this is 1, 0, 0 means, in the x direction, you have to move one magnitude, one unit magnitude. So I will move like this and I will reach over here. My final destination is now in the x direction. It is okay. Now in the y direction it is 0, and in the z direction it is 0. So I will not move further. I will stop here, and then I can connect the origin and the final destination or final point. So you can see this is the red one is showing you 100 direction. It is okay. Any confusion?
Yes.
Shall I repeat? If you want me to repeat, you can ask me to repeat. Huh? And you have to show like this, just by an arrow mark. Huh? So this red arrow mark is showing you 100 direction. Direction means square bracket. Huh? So next is 110 direction. 110 directions make, that means in the x direction it is 1, in the y it is 1, but in the z it is 0. So how to move? So you, this is the origin. So you move 1 unit magnitude in the x direction, you reach over here. Fine, you will stop now. Again, in the y direction, you have to move 1 unit magnitude. So you will move like this. And you will reach over here, right? But in the z direction, it is 0. So you do not have to move further. You will stop over there. Now you connect this origin to this final destination point. Fine. So you can have a look, this one. So this is 110 direction, this blue one. It is okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now the last direction is 111 direction. This is also very simple. You start with this origin. You move 1 unit magnitude in the x direction. Then 1 unit magnitude in the y direction. Right? Then finally, 1 unit magnitude in the z direction. And finally, you stop here. And now you connect the origin and the this final destination point. So this is your 111 direction. So you can able to draw if there will be any other directions. It is okay. Okay, if yes, suppose sir. If suppose there will be -1, -1, -1 direction. Basically, we do not say -1, we say (-1, (-1, (-1). So how to draw it? Let me see who can answer. These are all positive directions. Huh? If there will be -1, -1, -1 or (-1, (-1, (-1) direction, how to draw that?
Sir, we have to extend.
See, the question is, if you want to draw -1, -1, (-1) direction, then it will be out of this unit cell or inside the unit cell?
Out of the unit cell.
Obviously out of the unit cell, because just have a look, this is positive x direction, that means negative x direction will be like this. It is okay. Similarly, if this is positive y direction, then negative y direction will be like this. Similarly, if this is positive z direction, then negative x direction will be like this. Fine. Now the question is (-1, (-1, (-1). So if you want to draw it and you are taking this one as an origin again, so this will be out of the unit cell. You can draw that, no problem. But we always try to show the direction inside the unit cell. So what we can do? Can anybody guess? Anyhow, you want to show the direction inside the unit cell. What we need to do?
Sir, we can represent it with dotted line.
Dotted line. See, if you represent that in dotted line, anyhow, it will be out of the unit cell. The question was, anyhow, you have to show the direction inside the unit cell, inside this cube. Like all, you can see all these directions are inside the cube. But once it becomes negative, means it will be outside the cube. No? So how to do that? Any idea? Just imagine what can be done. The hint is final direction means initial origin to the final destination point, right? Just you have to draw, you have to connect it. So what can be done? You have
there
to change
the triple one. We can put a circle and a dot there where we
no. You have to do what? You have to change the origin, right? Okay, just tell me. Now I will choose the origin, which one, so that it will be inside the unit cell. You can choose origin this one, or you can choose the origin of this one. You are getting my point? If suppose I choose this one as an origin, so my x-axis will be this one. You understood my point?
Sir, please repeat one second.
See, now our aim is to show minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, or I'm saying bar 1, bar 1, bar 1 direction. If I'll draw like, if I will choose this one as an origin, so the direction will be out of the unit cell. But I want to show the direction inside the unit cell only. So what I can do? I can change the origin. So if I'll choose the origin, now this point is an origin. This is 0, 0, 0, right? So now if this is the origin now, the crusher, just have a look. So this is the x-axis now. But this is negative x-axis, yes or no? If I'll, this is origin, if I'll move in this direction, this will be negative x, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? And yes. This will be negative y. And this will be negative z. Fine. So minus 1 will be, suppose I will start over here. If this is minus 1, so I'll go like this. From this origin, I will move one unit magnitude, minus 1 in x direction. Then again, minus 1 in y direction, I will move like this. Then finally, minus 1 in the z direction. So I will move like this. And I will reach over here. Now, this is the final destination point. So initial point was here and final point was here. So I can connect them. It is okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Just reverse of this one. You are getting my point. Okay. Similarly, suppose you want to draw bar 1, bar 1, 0. So how to proceed? So you can choose this one. Again, origin, no problem. This is the origin. So I will move negative, bar 1 means negative, negative sign. Huh? So I will move like this, bar 1. In the x direction, and also bar 1 in the y direction, and finally I'll not move z direction, it is 0. So I can connect this point and this point. It is okay now?
Yes, sir.
So this is the way you can represent the direction inside the unit cell, just by changing the origin. So the conclusion is what? The conclusion is you have to show direction in form of this one. In form of square bracket first. And second one is, if you want to show negative direction, then you have to change the origin so that you can show the direction inside the unit cell. And direction means it is a vector actually. It is a vector which is connecting the origin and the final destination point. I think it is clear up to this. Huh? Now, this is another question. Find the crystallographic direction of a given line vector. As I told, crystallographic direction is nothing but the line vector. Fine. Find the crystallographic direction of a given line vector with help of projections. Okay, so this is given. Now a direction is given. Now you have to find out the magnitude. Let me see who can find it out quickly.
Half zero.
Okay, anybody want to try? He's saying half zero. You try by yourself. Let me see. I'm giving you 1 minute.
Sir, half 1 0.
Half 1 0, yes, sir.
I want answer from girls also. Let me see who is trying. You draw it quickly. You can draw the diagram and you can try it by yourself. What is the magnitude? What is the Miller? That means I want to find out the Miller indices of this given blue direction. Finally, answer will be in form of what? You have to put a square bracket and you have to write 3 magnitude. One for x, one for y, and one for z. That is the final answer. So final answer will be in form of this, like this, square bracket, okay, no, square bracket and a magnitude or something. Okay, nobody is trying. What will the answer? Yeah, few of them have answered. Okay. Okay, let me try. Huh? So you can take the help of projection. So projection means, see, this is the final point. So from the final point, I will draw a projection to the x direction. You can see this is x axis. This is y. And this is z. Fine. So I will draw a projection from this here to x direction. If I will draw a projection, I will reach to a point like this. It is okay. So this much of distance is half, right? And I will draw a projection to the y direction. From here, I will draw a projection in y direction. So this is cutting completely in one unit magnitude. So this is y is equal to 1. But I cannot draw a projection to z because there is no movement in the z direction, right? So this is... projection will be half and this projection is 1 and in the z it is 0. It is okay, fine.
Yes sir.
Half, then it is 1 and it is 0 and you have to put it inside a square bracket like this. So this is the direction. But something is wrong with this. Can anybody tell me what is wrong with this? See, you can go, you can reach this direction by one another method, right? Suppose this is the origin. So you have to reach this destination finally. So you start with origin, you move to half unit distance from in the x direction. And from here, you can move to y direction, one unit magnitude. Then you can reach to this point. So again, this is half and one, but in the z direction it is zero. In that way also you can do, or you can take the help of projections. Fine. So anything wrong with this, just have a look. Just have a look to these things and tell me anything wrong with that notation. Just have a look to this notations. This is half. We basically represent in form of integers, not as a half, basically. That means we do not have to use any kind of fractions. So what can be done? Can anybody guess?
1, 2, 0.
This will be?
So 1, 2, 0.
So what you need to do? Just multiply this one with?
2.
Right? You have to multiply half into 2. 1 into 2 and 0 into 2. So finally, you can represent this one as, it will be how much? 1, then 2, then 0. This is okay now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is the way to represent finally Miller indices of the given direction. So if there will be a question, direction will be given and you have to find out the Miller indices of the direction and finally you have to represent that in form of this. Square bracket means direction and this is for x, this is for y and this is for z. And this is a three coordinate system. Fine. Okay, now...
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
We are having lab classes now.
Okay, I will take only 5 minutes more. Huh? I will end this topic over here. Huh?
Okay, sir.
So, okay, fine. This is an assignment. Huh? Take this one as an assignment. Draw 1, minus 1 and 0. But I should not write minus 1. To make it easy, I have written minus 1. You should write 1, 1 bar and 0. Right? So, again, if you want to represent this minus 1, so it will be out of the unit cell. So, there are two things you can do. You can make another unit cell. You can draw that. Or you can change the origin. It is okay? And this is another direction, 2, 1, 1 direction. It is very easy again. You can draw another unit cell, you can draw it, or you can do something else. Next one is, okay. draw this line in a cube. Okay, just draw it. Let me see who can draw it quickly. It will take 5 minutes maximum. You can draw a single cube, and in that single cube you can draw all these directions. Let me see who can do it first. Take 5 minutes only. So this is 1 bar, huh? 1 bar means minus 1. This is 2 bar. 2 bar means minus 2. Just let me know who is done with the answer. Just let me know. Okay, just have a look, quickly. So this is 0, 1, 0 direction. So I will take the origin here. So I will move 0 direction in the x. In the y direction, I will move 1 unit distance. And the z direction, I have to move 0 magnitude. So finally, the direction is this one, 0, 1, 0, right? Then now 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1 means this is the origin. So I will not move in the x direction because it is 0. In the y direction, I will move 1 unit magnitude. So I will move like this. Then in the z direction, I have to move 1 unit magnitude. Again, I will move like this. So this is the final point. So I will join the origin and the final point. So this is the direction of 0, 1, 1. Now this is 1, 1, 1. So just have a look. So this is the origin. So I will move 1 unit magnitude in the x direction, 1 unit magnitude in the y direction, and 1 unit magnitude in the z direction. So I will reach at this point. So I will connect the origin and this point. So this is 1, 1, 1 direction. Similarly, 0, 2, 1 direction. So you can make another unit cell, or you can do reduction of this quantity too. You can move 0 in the x direction, 2 unit magnitude in the y direction, and 1 unit magnitude in the z direction, suppose. So you can connect them. You will get this point again. Same point you will get. Or you can reduce this value of 2. Similarly, you can also reduce this value of 2 to. But for this one, this is simple. Minus, negative minus 1 means, suppose I am choosing origin this one. This is the origin. So I will move 1 unit magnitude in the negative direction of the x. So I will move like this. This is x-axis. So this negative x-axis, right? Then 1 unit magnitude in the y direction. So this is like this. But in the z axis, this is 0. So I'll stop over here. So I'll connect the origin and the final point. So this is bar 1, 1, 0 direction. It is okay? I think it is clear up to this. Sir? You can draw any
yes,
directions
sir.
Now. Okay, fine. So you can leave right now.
Thanks, sir.